Hey, in this video, I'd like to show how you can have a simple web interface for your Git server that looks like something like this. That's for my own personal server, and you can see you have a list of repositories, and let's say I go on one of them. Here, you can see you have a small summary. You can go in the logs, you can explore the files. There is actually syntax highlighting, although I think I'll cover that later. You can see the commit diff. I can do the, I think, yeah, I don't know, never use that one, but you can see the diff and so on. And you have a README as well. All right, let's get into it. So let's go in the test server. And what you will need for this is apt install. And yeah, the application I'm using to make this website is cgit. And yeah, it's a. So yeah, in the last video, I said that it was going to be a static website, and that was actually the old way I did it now. But cgit is still very simple. But it's not static, it's a dynamic website. cgit, you're gonna need nginx for the HTTP server and fcgi wrap, which will do the translation between nginx and cgit. Next, we're gonna modify the config of cgit, which is in cgitrc. And I've already prepared some config for this. Up. And if you remember from the previous video, we have all our Git repositories are in var slash git. So I will quickly explain. So CSS and logo, you can guess. Those don't matter. Clone prefix, that's so in the website, if you go, let's say here, and zoom in a bit as well, you can clone the repo actually with the HTTP. So and here you should put your website's domain name. Here title description you can probably guess. Here it's the README that will be in the about page, and here is the important one. As I said, it has to be the last line in the config, and this is the directory that is going to be scanned by cgit to find the repositories. There is also the option of listing the repositories you want one by one, and then you can really detail, like have very specific options per repositories. That's what I do in my real config, but that is the simplest to get started. Next, you're gonna go in the nginx folder, sites available, and let's create an nginx config. Let's name it cgit. Which I already did. I forgot to remove that. That was from my test. But as you can see, very simple server that listens to port 80. And then there is some stuff for cgit. And yeah, we use fast CGI to the program fcgi wrap. And you have to give it some. The actual important parameter that may vary for your server are here. You have to put your where are your Git repositories, and that's about it, I think. I'll put that config, I mean all the configs, in the description. So next we have to do lns /etc/nginx site available cgit to /etc/nginx sites enabled cgit. I already did it in the previous stuff, and let's make sure sites enabled. There is only cgit. Yeah, you have to remove the default one for that to work. But then we do systemctl rista. Let's do systemctl start nginx. Now we should be able to, if we go to this IP address, this one. In real life, I suppose you have a domain name, huh? But I'm doing it the scuffed way. And you can see we have all the repo we created in the last video. And I think we created a... Yeah, I'm gonna zoom in a bit. But if we go in the full repo, you can see that, yeah, you can see the commit and the branch and all everything that I had on my server. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Yeah, for your config available cgit, you will probably have something like you will have a domain name, and then here you will put like server name, and then git, and then your domain.com, and then when you do go to that domain, you will have your git frontend. Yeah, before I was using stagit, which I will put a link into in the description, which is a bit more minimalistic, but it was more of a pain to set up, so I decided to use cgit for this video. Yeah, that's it. I think in the next video I'd like to show maybe how to quickly customize a bit cgit, because right now there is no file highlighting or stuff like that. So yeah, just the bare bones of to make it a minimum pretty. See you.